Find the image of a quadrant x greater than 1 and y greater than 0, that quadrant can be represented as in the figure under the transformation omega is equal to 1 by z. So we are taking omega is equal to u plus iv, where a real part is u, imaginary part is y, and is equal to 1 by z, so 1 by x plus iy. So now what we are going to do is we are going to change the coordinate x and y in terms of u and v. So we know x plus iy is equal to, that is 1 by omega is equal to z, that is x plus iy is equal to 1 by u plus iv. Now multiplying with the u minus iv in numerator and denominator, we will get this as a u square plus v square. So x plus iy is equal to, that is, so now equating real part, x is equal to u by u square plus v square, and y is equal to minus v by u square plus v square. But we already know x is greater than 1, that means u by u square plus v square is greater than 1. So u is greater than u square plus v square. So 0 greater than u square plus minus u plus v square. Similarly, this is an equation of circle. Similarly, we can get this is greater than 0, that is minus v is greater than 0. Let it be there. So v is less than 0. Now u square minus u plus v square is nothing but the, it is similar to u minus half the whole square plus v square is equal to 1 by 4. That means this is actually a circle with the center in uv coordinate. This is actually a circle with the center at a half 0 and with the radius half, that is, this is the same circle as shown in figure, and v is less than 0, that means this portion. So the infinity boundary condition, we are changing it into a small part such that we can easily convey the messages. That's what we are doing with the transformation omega is equal to 1 by z. We are changing this x and y coordinate into some feasible coordinate system. We can observe it clearly.